Yesterday, May 8th, the organizers of the Matters Day celebrations at the Anglican site in Namgongo, Kampala, organized a media tour. The tour, which was led by Right Reverend Reuben Kisembo, the Bishop of Rwenzori Diocese and Chairperson of the Organizing Committee, aimed to show the progress of the preparation of the Uganda Matters celebrations slated for June 3rd. This year's celebrations at the Anglican site will be led by the diocese from Rwenzori and Bunyoro sub-regions.
Basically, the program we run, we segmented the celebrations so that we don't have congestion on 3rd June. We shall begin with the Children's Day on 23rd of May here at Namgongo. All children from this country are invited to come and participate here. They have their talks and play and the topics that will be shared 23rd May. And the children who have not gone back to school, they are still at home. So 23rd June, another 23rd May, that's the Children's Day here at Namgongo Anglican site. Then 24th May will be a day for all the youth in this country.
Kisembo assured the media that they are fully prepared for the upcoming Uganda Matters celebrations. He also revealed that the Mid-Western Diocese Cluster also funded the 1,000-seater pavilion at the site. The media tour was attended by Bishop Nason Baluku of Rwenzori Diocese, Bishop Jackson Matovu, the chairperson of the Uganda Matters Development Committee, Bishop George William Asimwe from Masindi, and Venerable Geoffrey Wilson Kakoza of Luzira Archdeaconry. A number of local council chairpersons in Mbale City were briefed yesterday on their role of mobilizing their community members to participate in the National Census 2024. This briefing was spearheaded by the Mbale City Deputy Clerk, Kasim Wamboga. Wamboga says meeting with LCs was crucial because they're the key contact person in their communities who are going to play a key role in door-to-door mobilization of their members in their respective communities to take part in the census.
We have been meeting LC1s and LC2s, explaining to them their roles and responsibilities in the census, which starts on Friday, the 10th. And we have met, we have agreed modalities and everything.
The census exercise is slated for 10th May 2024. Rescuers race against time to find more survivors amid the rubble of a deadly building collapse in South Africa. Dozens of people are still unaccounted for, almost 60 hours after rescue services started combing through the debris in the southern city of George. At least 7 people were killed as an under-construction 5-story building collapsed. 29 of the 75 workers who were at the site when the incident occurred have been pulled out of the rubble alive, authorities said. 6 have life-threatening injuries and 16 are in critical condition. Moses Malala, a foreman who survived the collapse, told AFP that he heard a sound before the building came crashing down.
After that, I hear on my foot, I'm starting to slide. The time I'm checking down, I was sloping down, I was on top of the slab. And then starting to slide down, all my guys was going off one by one to go down on ground floor. Yeah, because the building is starting to fall in one side. Because starting on one side, directly in one side, and then starting to fall down.
39 people remain unaccounted for, authorities said. The next 3 hours are critical to save them, they added. The chances of surviving drop dramatically after 72 hours.